Welcome to my cave. It's a cave, it's just green. Today, I'm going to be talking about something I really didn't want to talk about on the channel, but I thought it was probably the best time to do something that we've never done today. And to start off with, I will do it on a high note. Hello, guys. I've never addressed the people who are watching. I hope you guys are doing well. As you can tell, I'm a little shaky. I'm a little nervous to talk about this because it's something that I think that's really been necessary to talk about for a long while here. And it has to do with a couple of the things on the channel. So to start off with, we're gonna be changing how we're doing things. And you know, maybe it has to do with maybe longer times between things or even longer formatted stuff, but mostly just it's probably going to be taking a back seat from now. And the biggest thing we're going to be talking about is psych. This is Cool Goblin Images. I like part 3. Yo, now that I've taken a shower and I'm no longer green, I want to talk about the goblins. We're going to be looking at goblins I found while reading a shit ton of manga and manhwa, but mostly manga. So the first one here is, check that out, dude. That's a goblin king. Now, I don't know about you guys, but there's something majestic about a big goblin in a throne. This guy's got two giant swords, which, I mean, I don't know, this guy just looks cool, you know what I mean? He's probably going to, like, do some goblin stuff. Definitely going to get killed in the next panel, but that's how goblins in manga go. Oh, this next guy. I remember this guy. This guy was like one of those like joke goblins in a manga, right? He was used as a panel of just like nothing, because he's a joke. This guy's a joke. He's funny though. He looks good. I like how he looks. Now this guy's pretty cool. I mean, look at this little dude, alright? You can't tell me that he isn't just like as mysterious as they come. And they're talking about like the auxiliary magic or some other bullshit in this. You know, you can't go wrong with that. I think, you know, if one had to be a goblin, I think a goblin mage would probably be up there in terms of which goblin you would be, because I just think he looks cool, right? He's mysterious. Now, if we're talking about real goblins, and when I say real goblins, I'm not talking about like real goblins. I'm talking about real goblins. This guy's a real one. I mean, he's giant, first of all. He's an emperor goblin. When I read this, I was genuinely stunned. I was laying in bed reading this shit, and I was like, what am I looking at, right? I just think it's, I mean, as the texts say, it's not a usual goblin. Now these guys rock. I like these guys because they're from a manga that I really enjoyed. It was like Isekai Samurai or Samurai in Another World, some crap like that. But I like how they're drawn. They're kind of drawn, I think, how goblins should be done, in kind of a haphazard, joking way, it feels like. I mean, obviously, it's not fully in this case. It's very well done, of course. All of these goblins are very well done. But these guys really speak to my heart. They, especially the guy on the bottom right, they really kind of scream Clash Royale Goblin, you know what I mean? But in a more cool way. Now, this goblin, I'm not 100%, like, into this goblin yet. He's got a lot of the goblin features that I dig, and he's got some like side goblins with him, right? And those guys are a little bit more goblin-y. But this guy, he's a bit weird because he's like a spider goblin. And I'm not really into that fully, but you know, that's a goblin, so I had to save it. I'm sure he's pretty good at doing stereotypical goblin shit, you know? He probably does that too, but also probably does what spiders does. You know what, actually, it kind of reminds me of Man Spider. You guys remember that? Man spider? Now these poor guys are some very hungry goblins. They need food. They're dying of hunger. They're still dying of hunger. They need food to hunger, goblins. I like this frame specifically, actually, because come on, that's a pretty good image. Can't tell me that's not. That's like banner image type of crap, right? Oh, there are big tears in their eyes. These are some personified goblins, in fact. So I think the artist has really rendered in the human emotion within these goblins. Some might even say they've been, and this goblin, you know, well, yeah, he's fine, I guess. He's kind of mediocre looking. He's fine. Either way, this is a sword lady swinging a sword at these, like, cuter looking goblins. Man, they're kind of cute, though, aren't they? Now, here's another frame. This is a goblin dying. He's dead. Now, check out these boys. These guys look pretty cool, all right? They're just, I don't know, they're, like, getting ready for, like, a war thing. See, it's been, oh, I remember what this is from. Yeah, this is from that one manga that updates, like, once every like, year and a half. More goblins. Look, these guys are pretty cool. These guys are playing, like, ball or something with the, you know, with the skull. I think that's pretty cool. 7 out of 10 goblin. Now, look at this guy. I'm gonna be honest, this guy looks a little weird, right? He looks a little strange, a little odd, especially next to that orange creature. I don't know what that orange guy is. He's weird too, but the goblin's also weird, right? So you've got your typical goblin traits, kind of shorter stature, green, long ears, bald person. They're bald. Goblins are bald. Bald. Here's another one of those ones from the Isekai Samurai, or something like that. This guy rocks. I don't know, I just really like how this mangaka draws goblins. I think they just draw goblins really well. I mean, look at this guy. This guy rocks. I mean, nice bold, like, line art and everything like that. And he's got, like, a shocked God, it's so expressive. He's such an expressive goblin. 10 out of 10 goblins. Love this goblin. Now, this is only, like, half a frame of a goblin. I don't know why it's only half a frame. He's either attacking or getting attacked. I think he's attacking. But if you look at his face, he looks kind of like the Harry Potter goblins a little bit. Except for he's got some spiky horn bits. So, I don't know. It's like a 6 out of 10 goblin. Now here's another one of those dead goblins. Put another counter on the dead goblin counter. Because there's another dead one. Here's a goblin war tribe. Goblin war tribe. Goblin war tribe, alright? Goblins. We're going back to the Samurai in Another World manga, where, gosh dang it, you know, they really just, this manga, I'm gonna put their name on the screen, because, my god, they just draw these goblins immaculately. And if you look at this goblin, and I finally get to use this in a fun sense, this goblin isn't just your typical goblin. This goblin, sure, a goblin king. I mean, he's even got the crown. But this goblin is a gestalt of many other tiny goblins, right? So you're telling me goblins fused together, like in Dragon Ball, and became one giant goblin king? There's nothing better than that. And look at his face, dude. This guy's ready for battle. I'm pretty sure he dies in the next frame. But man, does he look cool, right? I would say, if I had to pick a goblin, I had to pick a goblin. I would pick this goblin. The big goblin. Another goblin, you know, been stabbed in the back by a goblin arrow that another goblin shot. And the goblin arrowed. 10 out of 10. Hey, I'm back. It's been half a week. My footage ran out of space, so I stopped recording. But let's pick up where we left off, right? So here's an ugly-looking goblin, and he's got a really weird, like, bulbous head. Like a weird protrusion, you know what I mean? Shouldn't look like that, but it does, and he's a goblin, and he's in a fight scene. Next goblin. Now this goblin I find to be very special and dear to my heart. And I say this in full sincerity, and the reason why I say that is because if you look at his face... This goblin, he's got a plan. He just picked up that unicorn's horn and he's ready to wield it. He's ready to slay whoever took down that goblin behind him. I also just think he looks kind of funny. Now, I think this is a Goblin Slayer goblin. I'm pretty sure. They tend to be. It's a shame that a lot of goblins die in that manga. But in this case, you know, for what it's worth, the Goblin Slayer draws really good goblins. It's about killing goblins, but man, they just draw great goblins. You know, in this case, it's a shaman goblin speaking some ancient language of goblinese, probably, if I had to guess. Another set of three! One of the common manga tropes of using goblins as a benchmark for enemies in the fantasy world, and this one is just saying, these are goblins. I think they look pretty cool. Definitely like a pack of thugs. So I would say it's you know, a classic 9 out of 10 goblin. You know, these ones are a bit weird looking. They remind me a bit of that one Berserk scene. I'm sure one of them. I haven't watched Berserk, but it looks like that. Alright, so we got another cool goblin here. I respect this guy. And this guy looks, you know, not... I would say this goblin is pretty sweet, not just because he's got a giant flaming sword, but because look at his stance, all right? Now he's kind of in like a, you know what I mean? He's ready to go. He's kind of in this kind of stance, you know what I mean? He's like a boxer almost. So this goblin has trained, he's taken his time to at least attempt to figure out how to use this weapon, to wield this might of a sword, to defeat his enemies. I'm pretty sure he also dies the next frame. 9 out of 10 goblin. Alrighty, this artist has a very unique style of drawing goblins and rendering them. They do kind of a standard hash style, where they just kind of line in the shadows and stuff like that. I'm a big fan of hashing. I like to think that this is like a goblin king or a goblin general speaking to his goblin army or goblin platoon. So I like this one. This is a 10 out of 10 for me. Now here's one of those special kind of goblins. These goblins are really nice because just look at that grin. Look at that smirk, dude. Oh, I love a big wide smirk on a goblin. There's nothing... I personally believe the more a goblin grins, the more a goblin wins, if that makes any sense. Either way, I genuinely do really... I like how mischievous these guys feel. I like how mischievous... some might say. Yeah, so here's the last goblin here. I think this is a Goblin Slayer one, and you can kind of denote the Goblin Slayer ones by having a particular almost glimmer in the eyes of goblins. I don't know, they do the eyes well. They do the eyes very well on how they, you know, personify their characters. So I'm a big fan of that. You know, the crazier the goblin's eyes, the crazier the goblin typically is. In this case, the goblin is crazy. Proper bonkers. And on that note, thank you for watching Cool Goblin Images I Like Part 3. This has been Cool Goblins, 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 Goblin.